here at VMworld in San Francisco, and we're speaking with Datrium. Can you tell us a little bit about the company and what you're showing here at VMworld?
Hey, welcome everybody to the VMworld. We are at the Datrium booth today. So what Datrium does is that we provide a platform for doing primary backup and DR to the cloud in one single unified way of doing it. And customers run our platform on-prem to run their VMware workloads. And we provide a DR as a service to VMware Cloud on AWS. So you can do backup to the cloud, and you can do DR to VMware Cloud on AWS. It's a one unified platform, simplifies IT, and it one-click operations for everything we do.
And how do you work together with VMware and fit into their ecosystem?
Yeah, so we're very good partners with VMware. In fact, two of our founders come from VMware as well. And we also have Diane Greene and the other founders of VMware as investors in the company. So we work really close with them. They've been very good partners with us as well. And they allowed us to be part of their new VMware Cloud on AWS offering. We're the first, world's first and only backup and DR services to VMware Cloud on AWS as a SaaS service.
And so you had that announcement here at VMworld. Can you tell me a little bit about that DR announcement?
Oh yeah, awesome. So if you look at any company wants to have business continuity, so they have a DR site, but that's the old way of thinking about it. The cloud is here, dynamic resources, elastic resources. So what we're providing is a very cost-effective way of doing backup services in the cloud in Amazon. It's a full SaaS service, one support, one bill. And dynamically, when you actually have a disaster, we will launch VMware servers that you can then consume. It looks the same everywhere when you have a disaster, and then when you push a button, it'll bring everything down and bring it back. The idea is that it's cloud, elastic. Why pay for things that you don't have to, and you only pay for disaster when you actually have the disaster. It's like paying for insurance after the disaster.
And we've been talking with some of the people here at VMworld and asking them, where do you see the industry going over the next 12 months?
Yeah, so I talked to a lot of CIOs, and the one thing consistently I hear from every CIO is that they want to move fast, they want the cloud-first strategy. When they mean cloud-first strategy, what they don't mean is Amazon or Azure. They just want to be able to move faster, agile, enable the developers to be a more rapid production, right?
Right.
So if you look at the world, in the multi-cloud world, there are two things to consider. There is the compute plane, and there's a data plane. The compute plane is basically orchestration services like VMware and Kubernetes. That's going to be uniform everywhere. But what's missing in the world today is a multi-cloud data plane, which has data services, which is uniform, like primary, backup, and DR. They're all very different on each platform, on each cloud. So what we're trying to do is make that a uniform data services across all the clouds. We believe the world is going to end up there. Cloud is just another data center. Let's use it. Let's consume it for our benefit.
And is there something that we could take a look at? Maybe take a look at that new product that you were talking about?
Yeah, happy to show a demo for you. It's pretty slick, pretty easy to demonstrate the product.
So what are you going to show us?
What I'm going to show you is our global dashboard, and I'll demonstrate to you how easy it is to fail over from one side to the other with simple operations and a DR automation.
Great.
This is our global dashboard. It's a SaaS view into your entire data center and all your sites and into the cloud as well. So what I'm showing here is your HQ site on-prem where our software runs, and another site HQ2. This is a physical sites, and then these arrows imply you're basically replicating data from one side to the other in a multi-directional way, and also we can back up data to the cloud as well. This is our software runs here. It's called the Cloud DVX. And on demand, we will launch the VMware servers, SDDC on Amazon as well, when you actually push the button. So what I'm going to demonstrate to you right now is a kind of a failover, an example of how easy it is to operate and how easy it is to test it. So with that, so this is a tab showing you all the DR plans you have to do. And part of the DR is that you must do runbook automation. So we make it very easy to set up runbook automation. So I'll show an example.
Thank you.
So here's the plan, which kind of is a runbook workflow of, you can set up all the ways you need to do to failover. Because when you do failover, you have to consider the IP address changes, what is the order of bringing up things, like DNS comes up first, applications comes up next, all those kind of things. So you have multiple choices here. You can failover from prem to prem, or you can failover from prem to the cloud. So there are multiple options you can choose in one simple UI. And lastly, And the lastly, what we also do, because we own primary backup in DR, we do full compliance checks. One of the problems with DR is that you have to do fire drills constantly to know that your DR is going to work for you. Because we own all the three pieces, we are in a unique position to do compliance checks every half an hour so that we can tell you if something is broken right away and you get an email saying that, hey, this is broken, fix it right now. That gives people confidence in what how they feel about DR.
And just by way of explanation.
So let me kind of click on this and show you how it operates. So when you click on a DR plan, you have two options, either failover or you can do a test plan. Test plan is like a fire drill. If you want to do it, you can do it.
Sure.
And I'll hit the test plan right now. So when you do a failover, when you do a test plan or a failover, one of the things these days people are disaster is not just disaster like physical site failure, it's also ransomware attacks. So what you're offering is that when you fail over or do a testing, you can also go back in time to a previous snapshot. So you can choose as long, as old as you want, like 5 minutes ago or 1 hour, 1 day, 1 year, 5 years, and you can pick the backup you want to go back to and then load it up. So in this case, and then it shows you what steps we're going to do and just type in the confirmation.
Expand these, steps are kicking off, some recovery's going on, activity.
So it shows you all the steps it's going to do, one by one. And because we are primary and backup together, you don't have to do rehydration of data. It comes up right away. The time taken is mostly to register the VMs into vCenter and can I just power on the VM. That's all it takes.
Maybe saving some money.
I could have showed you the vCenter also, but I'm just in the interest of time, I'm going to show you our UI. So it shows you what all it's doing to bring up all the VMs on the other side. Actually, it's done. So at this point, you can go to vCenter and verify that all your VMs are correct and everything looks good. And when you're done with this is the testing, right? So you can say, you know what, I'm done with it. Let me clean up.
Expand the steps, recording the time.
And it does the opposite steps of what it just did. And here are the cleanup steps. It'll delete the VMs, unregister the VMs, and bring it back to the state where it was. This is non-disruptive, doesn't impact your existing primary workloads, doesn't impact anything really. It just kind of, in the background, brings up and deletes stuff. So everything is powered off. I believe it's all done. So at this point, you've done your testing. You can say, hey, all good, take some notes.
In fact, I can probably show you this while I'm running this test.
And acknowledge and say we're done. So, and then, most of the reasons why you would want to do testing and why you want to do DR also is that you want to also have captured the audit reports. So we have all the audits reports are completely always maintained in our platform. So you can go back in time and get any report you want to. Now let me show you one of the reports we have and how it looks like. It takes a couple of seconds to bring it up based on my Wi-Fi here. Okay, here's a report. So it shows you what all did you do, how did you configure it. It took 18 seconds to recover, RTO is 18 seconds. And it shows you all the mappings you have done. And then it kind of walks through all the steps we did to bring up the workloads and everything else. It's all green. In case something is wrong, it'll show orange so they can go fix it right now if you want to. It's as simple as that. And in addition, what we are doing is that we are able to do the compliance checks here every half an hour. What it means is that we will check the site one, site two, everything else in the process so that you know that it's always going to work for you. Confidence is what we want to give, and that's what we provide for our end user customers.
Great. And where can our viewers go if they want to find out more information about Datrium?
The best thing to do is go to our website, datrium.com, and we have all the information there. And if you want to do demos, we're happy to schedule a demo for you as well.
Well, thanks for taking the time to speak with VMblog.
Thank you. Excited to be here.